Error messages. They're an annoying but necessary part of any user experience. Jacob Nielsen even mentions them in his 9th usability heuristic. Help users recognize, diagnose, and recover from errors. Poorly designed error messages can drive users away from your product or service. So UX designers must be careful with these disappointing moments. If you want to create effective error messages, there's 3 dimensions to keep in mind. The first is visibility, how the error message presents itself to users. The second is communication, what the error message says about the problem in solutions. We have videos covering those, but in this video, we're going to talk about the 3rd dimension, efficiency. Error messages should do more than stop users from doing something the system can't support. They should also respect the user's effort and time. Efficient error messages give users solutions to return to their workflow or provide instruction to aid understanding and avoid the problem in the future. These 4 guidelines define efficiency. The first is to safeguard against likely mistakes. The very worst error messages are those that don't exist. When users make mistakes and don't receive feedback, it can mislead them and result in wasted effort and frustration. Here's an example. Most email apps will display a message when sending an email mentioning an attachment without a file attached. Detecting this situation before sending can spare you the work of resending the email and perhaps avoid some embarrassment. The second efficiency guideline is to preserve the user's input. Users don't type or touch click frivolously. Their input is precious, and it shouldn't be discarded, even if it doesn't meet the system's requirements. Let users correct errors by editing their original information instead of starting over. For example, display the original input entered into a form field, even if it doesn't match the field's requirements, and allow users to change it. The third guideline is to reduce error correction effort. Whenever possible, offer users several likely fixes to the situation and make it easy to select one. For example, if the city and zip code don't match on the form, offer a suggestion that would match instead. This results in less overall effort than retyping in the form. The fourth and final guideline is to concisely educate on how the system works. That does not mean giving detailed technical explanations of what happened. Instead, facilitate understanding of why the system had trouble meeting the user's expectations with words they'll understand. Use these moments to briefly coach users about the system to help them avoid repeating the error. This coaching can be included in the error message itself or as features that link users to help resources. For example, AI chatbots may respond with guidance to help users write successful prompts in the future. Or they may even offer suggested prompts that further clarify what the system is capable of executing or allowed to perform. By following these guidelines, you'll reduce frustration during these disappointing interactions and help users efficiently return to using your product or service.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 UX articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offers live, hands-on UX training.